is a very famous reference of Surah Ali Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 135. I'm going to quote this verse, but in order to comprehend it, we must know the verse before it. So this segment says, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. The meaning of this segment of set of verses, it says, and those who, when they have committed illegal sexual relationship, an illicit act, or they wrong themselves with evil, they immediately remember Allah, and then they ask for forgiveness for their sins. And then Allah says, none can forgive sins but He, but Allah. And they do not persist in what wrong they have done while they know. Now, since you already know the meaning of this segment, let me tell you this. Some of the verses, you cannot take them out of context. Like, you know, this ayah is talking about certain kind of people, a category of those who commit sins, including illicit acts, then they seek forgiveness and they do not persist. What? I mean, what is for them? Oh, that was mentioned in the previous ayah. Sometimes it is mentioned in the following ayah. This time it is mentioned in the previous ayah. So it says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَّبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُنفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Then, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعْلُوا فَاحِشَةً. So, the bishara is delivered in the previous ayah, the glad tidings. Allah the Almighty says, be quick, you all together, all you believe, be quick, race towards what? Like he said in Surah Al-Hadid, سَابِقُوا, race, race. Be quick, race, you all, towards what? Forgiveness from your Lord and gardens as wide as the heavens and the earth has been prepared for the pious, for the God-fearing. So when it comes to forgiveness, do not wait, do not postpone, do not slow down, do not say one day, when I go for Hajj, when I go for Umrah, when Ramadan comes. I think a couple of days ago there was one of the viewers who was asking that I'm planning to quit smoking and repent once Ramadan enters, and Ramadan is less than 100 days away, just 3 months. So he said, I'm planning to repent and quit smoking once Ramadan begins. I said, you're not going to do that. If you're not strong enough to quit right now and waiting for Ramadan to come, but who gave you an assurance that you would make it? You would live until you witness Ramadan? I don't know. Every episode when I'm sitting here, and sometimes I feel like I'm not going to finish it. It's possible. How many people died live on air? Soccer players, boxers, wrestlers. Just yesterday, there was a game, soccer, a football game. And somebody died. A young man, very athletic, he swallowed his tongue and he was suffocated and he died. May Allah have mercy on him. So, when you say in a couple months or in a couple years, when I go for Hajj, when I reach certain age, when I quit working in the bank, I'm going to repent. I'm going to pray when I reach 20. I'm going to pray when I do this, when I stop having illicit relations. You put this on top of that and you say, I'm waiting until I achieve this. This is all of the plots of Satan in order to slow you down and hinder you from making that serious decision. سارعوا
Be quick.
And the ayah says, in order to be eligible for entering paradise, to enter heaven, which is as wide as the heavens and the earth, all this universe compared to heaven, which Allah has prepared for the pious, is nothing. In fact, the sound hadith, the messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, لَمَوْضِعُ سَوْطِ أَحَدِكُمْ فِي الْجَنَّةِ خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. He's addressing the Arab, the Bedouins. They didn't have cars, but they used to do what? Ride on the back of the camels and horses and donkeys and mules. So they needed what? A stick or a whip. So you'll find everyone having his whip or his stick, huh, beneath his arm, because he goes around with it. So he says, if you happen to possess a spot in heaven which is as little as the spot of a stick in heaven, by Allah, this is indeed greater and better for you than the whole world and what it contains. MashaAllah. MashaAllah. But in order to set your foot in heaven, you've got to be forgiven. That's why he began by saying, be quick towards not entering Jannah. Be quick towards forgiveness. Be quick towards earning forgiveness. Be quick towards repenting, remitting your sins, and redemption. And then if you are accepted and your sins are being forgiven, you go straight to Jannah. In the sound hadith, the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, none shall enter paradise merely because of the amount of their good deeds. Some of the companions said, O Prophet of Allah, not even you, because all the companions were aware of the piety of Prophet Muhammad, the sincere devotion that he used to worship the Almighty Allah with. So after he finishes a day full of activities and teachings and prayers and ta'aleem, when everybody goes home, he stands up in prayer. His feet would swell of the long standing in the prayers. He may recite one third of the Quran in one single unit, you know. So they said, you know, he said, no one will be eligible to enter paradise because of the volume of their good deeds. Not even you. He said, not even me, unless if Allah includes me in his mercy. Unless if Allah showers his mercy upon me. Unless if Allah covers me with his mercy. إِلَّا أَن يَتَغَمَّدَنِ اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَتِهِ. So this is a message that no one should think I'm too good. What I've done Hajj and 3 Umrahs, so I know that I'm eligible to enter paradise. Or I give 5% instead of 2.5% of zakah. Or I support some orphans. Or I look after my young siblings after my father died, so I'm going straight to heaven. This is all good for yourself. If it is accepted, then this is a mercy from Allah and generosity. Then if it is accepted and you're rewarded, do you think this reward is sufficient to make you eligible to be in heaven? It's not sufficient. Because no matter what we do, we don't give enough thanks and appreciation to the countless blessings of the Almighty Allah. And that's why we need His mercy. That's why He said to enter heaven, you're going to gain forgiveness. Forgiveness for your sins and forgiveness for your shortcomings in doing what is required to do and what is even voluntary to make you eligible to enter. Then he mentioned among the qualities that they spend, those pious people were eligible to enter al-Jannah, which is as wide as the heavens and the earth. He said, الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين. The qualities they spend generously for the sake of Allah, whether in adversity or prosperity or in adversity. Not because they have some tight financial conditions, say I'm not giving anymore. No, they share with others. So this is a very, great quality. And they suppress the anger. Whenever they are capable to take revenge or punish those who have offended them, they refrain. They step back and say, for the sake of Allah, I suppress my anger. So they become eligible for His mercy. And furthermore, they pardon. They pardon those who have wronged them while they are capable to avenge them. You know, when somebody is weak and oppressed, and a ruler, an officer, or a muscular person happened to hurt him. So when he got off the car and he wants to take revenge and he found a humongous guy, he says, okay, I forgive you. No, you're not forgiving him. You protected yourself. You're not really forgiving him. You know that you cannot do anything with him. So it becomes harder to pardon and forgive when you have an access to revenge, when you're capable to take revenge. Subhanallah. Then in the following ayah 135, among the qualities of the pious who are eligible to enter paradise, that whenever they commit sins, they wrong themselves, they indulge into an illicit relationship, immediately they remember Allah, they remember that He is severe in torment, they remember that أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ وَنَسُوهُ, Allah has recorded everything, and He remembers, He does not forgive. So they are afraid they will be in trouble. So they rush to do what? Seek forgiveness for their sins. فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ. And who besides Allah forgives sins? The answer is in the negative, none. وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. Al-Israr is persistence. And that's why when somebody is drinking and says, oh Allah forgive me, I know this is haram, but oh Allah forgive me, that itself is a sin, because now the way that he seeks forgiveness requires forgiveness. He's not serious, he's joking, maybe he's sarcastic. A thief who is breaking into somebody's house and says, oh Allah protect me and make it easy for me to do what? To break into somebody's house and to steal? Does it make sense? No, it doesn't. So he's not eligible for forgiveness. وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا. They do not persist on committing the sins knowingly. But sometimes after we commit the sins and we seek forgiveness, then we get weak and we start over. So seek forgiveness again. Repent over and over and over again. As long as you are serious about seeking forgiveness, there is no israr, there is no persistence.